Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to restore a database in a SQL Server database engine. Typically, I'm going to demonstrate using one of the databases, that is AdventureWorks, that has been already backed up by Microsoft and they have published in the internet. And we are going to download it and then restore it to our local SQL Server engine. That is the exercise I'm going to do. So this is not only for AdventureWorks, any database that have been backed up can be restored using this method. That is what I want to highlight. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So typically, like, what are the prerequisites for this exercise is, like, you need to have the SQL Server engine, that is database engine, and SQL Server Management Studio. So these two things, if you do not have, you cannot perform it. Basically, you are going to restore the database in this server. So that is prerequisite that you always may be already aware of it. And SSMS, that is SQL Server Management Studio, use it as a client tool that will help us to manage the databases. And if you do not know how to install this, I have a video for it. I will give it in the description. You can check it out if you not installed it yet. And what is the steps? The step involved, you need to download the AdventureWorks database. Then you can restore it into SQL Server using the SSMS. That's what we are going to do. Let's copy this URL and then go to Google. And URL, the web browser, put it in the web browser there you go. You have page where you have a backup of databases. All these, each and individual link here, that back file is nothing but the database backup. So this has taken on 2016-17-19 version. Maybe some data they have added more in this. So this is light version, and then this is the data warehouse version. So I would recommend someone who is trying to practice SQL, then I will recommend this particular OLTP version of backups. You can go for any one of them, not an issue. And if you are want to practice, you are so much beginner, you want to learn very slight SQL, and if you do not have a practice, then you can go for it. For those who are into data modeling and data warehouses, they can choose any one of the version. Let us go by two of them, one for data warehouse backup, another one light version, and we will download both, then we will try to restore it. So just clicking on it will prompt you to download over here, and as I already download, I will cancel this download here. Similarly, I am downloading the light version, then canceling it. Okay, so let's go and check my download folder here. You have two backup files, then it's like you need to go for the step two to restore. So this is the SSMS. If you do not know how to open it, just type in search SSMS. I have different versions here, so I will go for the latest version, SQL Server 2018. And once it opened, you need to connect to that server, then we will restore the database. Some people say, like, upload a database. That is not a correct terminology. In database world, you need to say it is a restore a database. So let's wait for it. So now we have SSMS. We have to connect to the server. My server is Naga SQL 2019. I'm connecting to it. Now here, I do not have any databases. I'm going to restore it now. It's new. It's not a new database. If you want to create new database, you can go for it. Now we are doing the restore database. So restore. And where that backup exists, this is exist in the device. Okay, device means file system. So you need to choose the device. So click on it, then click on add. So here some people getting confused. It should be stored in this path. So they will navigate to this path and put it here. No need to confuse here. Just you can take that backup file. So what I'm trying to say is, if you take this downloads folder and put it over here, right, in the downloads, then put refresh or enter, this will say you cannot able to navigate to this path, all those things. So just take this downloaded file in some other folder. Okay, just go back here. I have created some folder here, analytics with NAC source AdventureWorks. Okay, just take this path, take that backup, put it in some other drives. Okay, C drive is not friendly. I'm not sure why it's happening, but I'm not, don't want to spend my time in that. So just navigate that part and put that path here and press refresh. So it will list down the backups. Let's go one by one. Let's do the light version. I'm clicking on light version and clicking on backup and restore. Click on OK. Now this will restore into like database, like, then click on OK. Click on OK. Once you click on OK, you go and check the status here. The database restored successfully. You can click refresh OK. Then you see the database refresh. You can see some of the tables here. You just go and query it so that you ensure that data also restored. So in this way, you can easily generate some data for your practice for querying, because creating a data is a nightmare. It will take a lot of time. So in this way, once you restore a database, you can easily work on the your queries. So now I'm doing it again for the second one. I mean to say the second database, that is AdventureWorks, so that if you miss in the first one, you can get it now, how you can do it. So once you add it, then click on OK. Okay, then it is fine. Again, you, if you want to change the name, if you say like I do not want 2019, you press DW, it will be restored in a new name. Absolutely fine. Just taking that backup and restored in the new name also, it's possible. So here it is somewhat much more data. You can query it to verify it. Everything has a data. I hope you understand how to restore a database from backup file into SQL Server. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.